Hello everyone, very good morning. So welcome to the final session of the current affairs of a UGC NET Commerce and Management 2021. Can you please confirm whether audio, video, everything is clear or not? Yes, good morning, good morning. Guys, today free sessions at An Academy free platform will be, or today total schedule at all platforms will be UGC NET Paper 1 and Paper 2 Commerce. AITAM we are taking most wanted current affairs final session. There will not be any other session after this. And before you are going for exam, I will conduct one more session with respect to current affairs of a commerce and paper 1, where we'll be covering the latest developed areas in the commerce. By that time, if anything ignored, I will be collecting all the details and I will be taking one more session to complete everything. And today free sessions will be 12 PM best 20-day strategy for the JRF with a daily timetable, and 5:30 PM most frequently asked questions of paper 1, 7 PM NTA professors most expected MCQs, and at 9 PM marathon on business finance MCQs or PYQs will be there. So here what you need to do is that download the Academy learning app is a step number one. Step number two, complete your sign up process with your mobile number as well as Gmail. After that, go to the An Academy my profile from the link given in the description. So just go to my profile Vodnala Shivlingam, and after that click on follow button in my profile at An Academy. After that, in my profile you can see one section called as in special classes, which are free classes. Later, click on notify me for the each of the upcoming live class, free live class which is scheduled, and enter the invite code Shiva Live to access to free live session at An Academy free platform, and attend the free live session at above scheduled time 8 AM, 12 PM, 5:30, 7 PM, 9 PM YouTube live at An Academy live NTA UGC NET. So most awaiting session is that which you are asking at An Academy free platform UGC NET 2021. At 12 p.m. best 20-day strategy with a clear-cut daily timetable to crack UGC NET or a JRF, which is your dream. For the last 20 days, we need to be very cautious to tackle. So that is what I'm going to discuss at 12 p.m. in this today's session. Today at 12 p.m. we'll be having. The link of this session is available in the Telegram as well as in my profile also. Do join into the Telegram, which I pinned in the chat box. Just click on that, or else go with the description and join over there. 5:30 and 7 PM most important free live sessions are there, which is paper 1 and KSA 2021 commerce paper part number 2 commerce 5 star PYQs will be there at 9 PM today. So not today, today we'll be having a business finance part 1 at a YouTube of An Academy live NTA UGC NET. And foundation as well as complete courses for the paper 1 and commerce are live now. So you can tomorrow morning 8 AM, by this time I will be live at An Academy Plus platform for the new course, which is a foundation course on paper 1 paper 2 commerce. So do not forget to subscribe to An Academy Plus platform. One subscription of An Academy will give you paper 1 paper 2 all educator session and their PDF material, mock test, quizzes, all will be under one roof. If you are aiming for the next long term preparation, this is the best course which is going to have ever. And it will be completing with a batch course with me. Niharika ma'am is going to be there on 27th of October. We will be starting, that is tomorrow morning 8 AM commerce, 7 PM paper 1 is going to start. Foundation means for 4 days we'll be having a basics. Later after that, from the 3rd of November, complete course will be entering. So various courses are live now, and you can take the subscription. If you take the 6 month plus subscription, you will be able to get 1 month additional for a free. And if you are taking a 24 months, you will get 3 months extra subscription for free. So do not forget to use my invite code Shiva Live to get 10% off on the subscription. And this will be your JRF code. If you use this code, you will get Pakka JRF. So which is an unlock code towards the JRF as well as 10% and total PDF material you will be getting at your step. So these are the various plans of An Academy platform where you can get it. I am recommending you to go for the 12 months subscription or 24 months offer is going on. To avail the offer 24 months or else 12 months also you can take it. So because this is a long term preparation oriented batch. Shall we start the current affair? Question number one. Guys, do hit the like button and subscribe to this channel, commerce.ugc.net. This is my own YouTube channel. If you haven't, aware about it. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Which multilateral association recently held a conference on biodiversity? This is paper 1, paper 2 mixed up one. Good morning, good morning. Guys, do hit the like button. Likes and this are not matching. See, if I tell about the PDF now like this, if I didn't tell about the PDF, that you will not get the PDF unless you attend the live session. This is the situation. If I tell about the PDF, you have seen the second part of this session, how the situation was. Hello, let it be. I don't want to force it. I will give the PDF those who attended today as well as yesterday. Which multilateral association held a conference on biodiversity? That is of Asian is a association which held a conference on biodiversity. Asian Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Conference on biodiversity held recently, and the fifth and final session of the conference focused on the theme of towards 2050 living in harmony with the nature. Please spell out the same in the chat box. Towards 2050 living in harmony with the nature, which is conducted by the Asian and biodiversity conference held recently. As per this, developing countries will need resources for the proper implementation of the post 2020 global biodiversity framework. The Asian includes a total 10 countries with respect to this organization, that is Brunei, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Myanmar, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam. Whether India is a member of this Asian, India is not a member of this nation, Asian. So India is not been part of this conference also. Next, which member country of the BRICS proposed the STI, led BRICS Innovation Cooperation Action Plan? Guys, do hit the like button and do subscribe to this channel. Good morning. Option C is the correct answer. C, that is India. So, which member country of a BRICS proposed SILX BRICS Innovation Cooperation Action Plan? So, that is Science and Technology Innovation. STI is the, in the sense Science and Technology. Led BRICS Innovation Cooperation Plan Action Plan have been proposed by the India only in the during the 12th meeting of the BRICS Science and Technology Meeting Committee hosted by the Department of Science and Technology. All the BRICS countries agreed to the Science and Technology Innovation Led Action Plan. It enables the sharing of experience of each other's innovation. Like I will give my country's innovation to your country and I will get to know about your country innovation. I will get to know, I will tell you about my country innovation. Like that, exchanging of innovation and science and technology will happen. Sharing of minds and sharing of a resources, not sharing of a resource, it is sharing of a like innovations ideas. That will develop the country to equip towards the innovation as well as research and development. Hi, Shalini ma'am. Good morning. Who are you? Myself, Vodnala Shivlingam. I am educator at an academy platform. As per the GST law, for how many years? Achha, you are telling to Shalini. As per the GST law, for how many years states were guaranteed to be compensated for loss of revenue in GST implementation? As per the GST law, for how many years states were guaranteed to be compensated for the loss of the GST implementation? So this is 5 years. 5 years it is, for a period of 5 years from the July 2017. It is applicable from the 1st of July 2017 plus 5 years. Government borrowed and released 75,000 crores to the states and union territories to compensate them for a shortfall in the GST revenue. And here this is an addition to a normal GST compensation being released for every 2 months out of the actual cess collection. So this aims to meet the resource gap due to a short release of a compensation. Good morning, Rekha. What is the FDI limit permitted under the automatic route for the renewable energy projects? 25%, 49%, 74%, 100%. This question looks like completed. Numbers and likes are not matching. Pop lagega bhaiya. In order to avoid the pop, you need to hit the like button. Hello Kushbu. So option D is the correct answer, 100%. I think this looks like completed, but slightly a different question. But let me check with that also. If the duplicated is there, I will remove one question. Government has permitted for the FDI FDI up to 100% under the automatic route. So renewable energy projects, including offshore and energy projects. Union Minister for the Power and New Renewable Energy, R.K. Singh, recently replied in Lok Sabha at the government notified National Offshore Wind Energy Policy 2015 to provide a basic framework for developing offshore wind sector. The government also enabled private sector to carry out the offshore wind resource assessment. Telecom sector also 100%. Yes, correct. Now I got it. As of March 31, 2021, what was the worth of a total non-performing assets of the Bank of India, banks in India? Oh, my fan came. Hello, my dear. How are you, my dear fan? AC, cooler. Automatic means without the approval of the government, where you can straight away enter without approval of the government. Direct route in the sense you have to take the approval of the government. So option C is the correct answer. 8.34 lakh crore total non-performing assets are there as on 31st March 2021. So are the bad banks of the bad loans of the bank, 8.34 lakhs. And these are gross loans and advance outstanding of a scheduled commercial bank to rouse to 113.99 lakh crores as on 31st March 2021. NPA is declined 61,000. Now it is 8.96. Previously on 2020, it was there. Total outstanding was there, but out of that NPA declared is that 8.34 lakhs only. Total loans are 113.99, but out of that NPA declared as 8.34. We all are your fans and ACs. No, 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 no. A fan separate here. A fan separate here. He is more than, he or she is more than you all. Factoring Regulation Amendment Bill 2020 is expected to improve the availability to credit to the which sector? Most important by Factoring Regulation Amendment Bill 2020. Option B is the correct answer, that is MSME sector only. You know, whatever the credit facility or borrowing related amendments or else initiations are coming, maximum questions are related to MSME, small and medium, like micro and small medium enterprises, all are related to that only, it is coming. So this is also related to that. Here the parliament this week passed a law to factoring regulation 2020 bill, which is factoring regulation act 2011. So factoring is an arrangement where the business sells receivables to the other agent to collect it and get it for a commission. So here, what are the benefits of a new law? The when the financial institutions such as NBFCs are willing to assume the risk of collecting a pending receivable, it leads to greater choice for the businessman in the MSME sector. So the new law is expected to improve the availability of credit of MSME sector, since the more non-banking financial companies will now eligible to lend it to the MSME sector by way of this process, by keeping that factoring as a base, and they will be releasing more of the loans. The buyer who purchases the receivables from the business later collect the cash from the party that owes those bills, means from the agent only, directly bank will be collecting to compensate the loan. So for instance, many of the MSME owners may not want to receive the payments, may not be willing to sell their receivables at discount. The risk associated with the collecting receivables can prevent those who are risk averse for entering into MSME space at all. Means for those people who wanted to get an immediate funding and those who wanted to get the loan from the MSME for the sake of MSME sector, but they don't have assets, the debtor's bills which is given to the factor will be taken as a base, and on that you will be getting a loan. Next, the Insurance Amendment Bill again allows a foreign investor to hold up to what percentage of capital in the Indian insurance company, which must be owned and controlled by the Indian entity. Now telecom sector over, renewable energy over, now it is of related to insurance sector. How much? Guys, do hit the like button. It is of 49%. Insurance Amendment Bill 2020-21, introduced in Raj Sabha by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman, on 2021 March 15 has introduced and amended this Act, Insurance Act 1938. It's an amendment. So where the Act provides a framework for the functioning of insurance business and regulate the relationship between the insurer and the policyholder. So here, under the IRDA only it will be working. The bill seeks to increase the maximum foreign investment allowed in the Indian insurance sector. Maximum matlab 49% have been allowed over here. So foreign investment act hold up to 49% of the capital in Indian insurance company must be owned and controlled by the Indian entity. Means remaining 51% must be owned by the Indian entity only. It should not be given to the foreign entity. So bill increase the limit of foreign investment in an insurance company from 49 to 74 and removing, wait. No, this is contradicting whatever the data is there. इट्स कंट्राडिक्टिंग, थोड़ा रुको भाई, वंस इंडियन गवर्नमेंट टीआई yes it's 74% by wait then I have to change this question how it can be a it must be 74 na then answer has to be 74% 49 previously now with this bill it increased to 49 to 74% 74 FDI and insurance what means policy holder Indian companies and promoters previously it was 49% now it increased to 74%. Please make a correction. It's my error, I think. 74% is correct. Again the polar. Morning, mind is not working. I given poll already. You are not getting. What to do? Your network is very weak. Cash is a top recipient state during the financial year 2021 with 37% of the FDI equity flows. Equity inflows. Yes, yes, Abhishek. I need to keep the 49 to make the mistake, right? So, Gujarat is the correct answer. That is, Gujarat is the top recipient of state during the financial year 2021. 37% of the FDI inflows are there into Gujarat only. Because he will bring always to Gujarat only everything. Other states are not important. Not much. 37% of the share of the FDI equity inflows followed by Maharashtra. Gujarat is standing at number 1, later Maharashtra, 27%, Karnataka, 13%, it is from the officials of government only. Can we expect a 20 bits in current affairs? No, bhai, 20 hai toh, then what we need to do with the remaining subjects? Not even 5 also you can expect, 5 is all enough, most probably 3 to 4 questions, 3 questions. According to scheme for a penalty, non-replenishment of ATMs. ATM where cash is out of more than dash hours in a month. Penalty of dash. This is completed already. Yesterday, last second session, we have done this question, but I have done in a different way. Now it is different. There the question I given in different way. Here the question is different, but important affair it is. 10 hours, 10,000. It is option C. RBI announced a launch of scheme of penalty non-replenishment ATMs with effect from the 1st of October 2021, where the ATMs are going out of the cash for a more than 10 hours in a month. Then they are liable for the 10,000 penalty per month, per ATM per month. Identify the correct statement in the context of e-rupee, launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently, e-rupee, electronic. It's a cashless, contactless instrument for the digital payment. Users will be liable to redeem the voucher without a card or an app. Our internet banking access. Option C is the correct answer. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi has launched a person and purpose specific digital payment solution which is named as an e-rupee. From the 2nd of August, in the video conferencing, 2nd of August, he introduced this one. It's a cashless, contactless instrument for the digital payment. It's a digital payment. and it is a QR code for the SMS string based e-voucher. Users will be able to redeem the voucher without any type of internet accessibility or the card or any app. It has been developed by the National Payment Corporation of India along with the Department of Financial Services under the Ministry of Health and National Health Authority. Is it developed by Ministry of Health and National Authority? कैसे कैसे हो सकता ई रूपी डेवलप्ड बाय यस इट इज बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर एंड नेशनल हेल्थ अथॉरिटी करेक्ट SIDBI has launched an app-based digital lending platform called as a Digital Prayas to sanction the loans to entrepreneurs from bad banks, foreign investors, corporate sector, low-income groups. Paper 1 I can't say, but paper 2 can be of a 3 to 4 out of 100. Digital Prayas. SIDBI, Small Industries Development Bank of India. So option D, because small industries is for the low income groups only. It is SIDBI launched the app based digital lending platform called as a Digital Prayas to sanction the loans to who are entrepreneurs, low income groups. Loan will be sanctioned at the end of the day, and SIDBI tied up with a big basket. Big basket, there is a to cater the needs of aspiring youth in urban areas and will onboard a big basket delivery partners and provides a loan at affordable interest rate for the purchase of environment friendly e-bikes, e-vans. Those loans can be provided to become an entrepreneur. Dash India, in a partnership with online lending platform IndiFi, has launched Small Business Loan Initiative in India. Facebook, Twitter, Microsoft, Amazon. Which big basket? This is there, na? Grocery supermarket wala. Set exam they can, but net I don't think so. So option A is the correct answer. Facebook it is. Facebook in India, and India is partnership with an online lending platform called as an IndiFi, I-N-D-I-F-I, has launched a small business loan initiative in India, and it is the first country where the Facebook is rolling out this program. Aim is to help and small and medium business to advertise on Facebook to get quick access credit or loans through independent lending partners. This will make the business loans more easily accessible for a small business, and which will be reducing a credit gap within the India MSME sector. Digital payment from Paytm has launched. Sorry, digital payment platform Paytm has launched a postpaid mini, a small ticket loan that will give a user's flexibility to access a loan ranging from dash to dash. Postpaid mini. Guys, do hit the like button. Still the likes and people are not matching. 15 members yet to give. So option number B is the correct answer. 250 to 1000 rupees. Rupees 250 to 1000 rupees. Postpaid mini. One initiative is being small ticket loan. That will give the flexibility to access 250 rupees to 1000 rupees. This is also loan. It was launched by the partnership with Aditya Birla Finance Limited, 250 rupees to 1000 rupees. The product is an extension of a it's buy now pay later service. Buy now pay later service, that loan will be same. It's an extension of that facility only. Driving affordability among us, the new to audit. And with this Paytm postpaid offering for a period of 30 days for repayment of a loan, 0% interest. Next, national monetization pipeline consists of a 4-year pipeline of the centers, foreign portfolio investment, foreign direct investment, greenfield infrastructure asset, brownfield infrastructure assets. Option number D is the correct answer. It's a brownfield. Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will has been launched a national monetization pipeline in the New Delhi, and it will list out the center infrastructure which will sold out over the next 4 years. Total whatever the infrastructure that central government is having, which will be selling for the next 4 years, and this 4-year pipeline of the central is a brownfield infrastructure assets only. And it will be brownfield means already started one. Greenfield means from the scratch. Brownfield is already established one that will be sold it to the private entities and they will be getting amount. It will be a medium term roadmap for the center asset monetization initiative to pull up the funds from various type of activities. As part of that only this will be selling to other. National monetization pipeline will book released on the occasion. This is another event. Next, Life Insurance Corporation has launched a new health insurance plan titled as an Arogya Rakshak, Arogya Setu, Arogya Jeevan, none of the above. When the AP set examination, can anyone please tell? So that is Arogya Rakshak. LIC launched a new health insurance plan titled as an Arogya Rakshak. It is not a non-linked, non-participating regular premium individual health insurance plan. It will provide a fixed insurance cover against the certified specific health risk. Provides a timely support in case of medical emergencies also. It will be available for the principal insurers and spouses and parents up to 80 years and children up to 25 years. Children up to 25 years. RBI has imposed, okay Sinduja, thank you Nikhil and Sinduja, Varalakshmi, thank you. RBI has imposed the restrictions on Dash Private Limited for adding a new domestic customers that will affect from the 22nd July 2021. Industrial sector, private bank, MasterCard, Asia are a specific, Pacific and commercial sector. That is option number C is the correct answer. MasterCard Asia Pacific Private Limited adding a new domestic customer with effect from 22nd July 2021. RBI put a restriction on these cards. Almost it is not allowed. MasterCard will not be allowed to add the customer for a debit and credit or a prepaid into its network as an entity. So it is failed to comply with the directions of on the storage payment system data of a circular 2018 April given by the RBI. That is why RBI has banned or restricted this entity. Union Cabinet has approved an increase in DA to a central government employees and dearness relief to a pensioner to dash from existing. कर लो भाई एक लाइक वन लाइक यस नंदिनी थर्ड वीक ऑफ डिसेंबर. So, dearness allowance increased by the central government. DA, new DA is the 28% from the existing 17%. Option A is the correct answer. Total increase to 28%, existing one was 17. So, this is Union Cabinet approval for the central government employees only. This will be applicable. The increased DA and the DR rates will be applicable from 1st of July 2021. It made it applicable. The hike represent almost 11% from the 28 to 17 means it is 11% got increased, which is of the basic pay or the basic pension. And they were put on hold from the January 2020 because of the COVID-19 only. Now they have given with a good percent, 11% hike have announced. Good morning. RBI has increased the incentive for the distribution of the coins over the counter from 25 rupees per bag to rupees dash of coin with effect from September 2021. AP said 31st. Yes, Nikhil, we can expect in the last one. Option B is the correct answer, that is. RBI increased the incentive for the distribution of coins over the counter from 25 per bag to 65 per bag of a coin with effect from the September 2021. It will provide incentive to the banks and currency chest under the currency distribution and exchange scheme for the distribution of coins over the counter to promote the circulation of the coins. If you distribute the more coins, the incentive for one bag of currency coins is that 65 rupees now per one bag they are going to get, and additional 10 rupees per bag will be there as an incentive would be paid for coin distribution in rural and semi-urban areas. If it is urban areas, 65 rupees per bag you are going to get it the more you promote the coins. Dash has received an insurance broking license from the Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India. Bheem, Google Pay, Paytm, RTGS. Option C is the correct answer. Paytm or phone pay. Phone pay, right? Wait, by options are wrong, I think. 1 minute. won't pay only. Paytm. In the 2020 only Paytm got it by, but in the 2021 PhonePe it is, which is Walmart owned company, owned initiative called as an PhonePe. PhonePe it is 2021 PhonePe, 2020 Paytm. Okay, in the 2021 PhonePe got the insurance broking license, direct broking license. PhonePe can now distribute insurance product for all the insurance companies on its platform. Hello, next. BharatPay ties up with a which bank on point of sale service? HDFC, SIDBI, SBI, Axis. Is it getting repeated? It is Axis Bank. BharatPay announced and this is already completed by Bharat Swipe, already done. Axis Bank it is. This association, I think one was there called as an HDFC point of sale. That is also there. Bharat something is there. And here Axis Bank, Bharat Swipe. Bharat Swipe is an Axis Bank. SEBI announced a detailed guideline for product labeling in Dash. Mutual fund, insurance and banking sector, MSME. I think looking like 2 to 3 repeated. So option A is the correct answer. Mutual fund. SBI announced a mutual fund detailed guideline for the labeling of the mutual fund. Earlier 5 categories to measure the level of risk in mutual fund. Now which is a regulator of SEBI introduced a one more category. That is total 6 categories to measure the level of a risk in mutual fund. SEBI is having a 6 type of categories, which is effect from the January 2021. Very high risk category got added. The Supreme Court warned that authorities have no choice, however, to represent the GST. It is appellate tribunal, GST appellate tribunal is there, GST AT. So Supreme Court warned that authorities have no choice however to represent the GST appellate tribunal. 4 years after the GST law passed in 2016, GST tribunal not yet has been established. So GST appellate tribunal second appeal forum for any dissatisfaction of the orders passed by the first appellate authority under the GST authority. The National Appellate Tribunal is additionally first common forum to resolve the disputes between the center and states. So a common forum called as a GST Appellate Tribunal has to be established, but till now it didn't got established. That is why Supreme Court want to establish that Appellate Tribunal separately. Identify the correct statement in the context of LLP Amendment Bill 2020-21. The bill converts a certain offenses into a civil defaults. It also defines a small LLP and establishment of a special courts. Who is that fan? I will not tell because he is special to me. I will not disclose his identity, very confidential. Nitya, how, why Nitya? Nitya will not do like that. Nitya is very good girl. So So option D is the correct answer, all of the above. Here, Bill is converting certain offenses into a civil offenses. You can look at like LLP amendment bill introduced the Rajya Sabha, and it is an alternate corporate body of a traditional partnership firm. Under this bill, converting certain offenses into a criminal offense to civil offenses, and changes in the nature of punishment of this offense also made. And it is clearly defined what is called as a small LLP also. It provides appointment for certain adjudicating officers and establishment of a special courts also had got a power with this amendment. Certain offenses discriminalized. So you can look at providing violating these requirements will be punishable with a fine of ranging from 2000 rupees to 5 lakh rupees. These requirements includes changes in the partnership of LLP and change of registered office, filing of a statement of account, solvency, annual return, arrangement between the LLP and the creditors and partners, reconstruction, amalgamation, LLP. So all these, if you are doing any type of changes within, if you are violating the requirement which required to be changed, you will be getting a penalty of 2000 rupees and 5 lakh also. And here you can also see adjudicating officer. Under the bill, central government may be appointed adjudicating officer for awarding a penalties under this act. And this will be a central government officer, not below the rank of registrar, will be appointing over here. Non-compliance order of the tribunal. Under this act, non-compliance order of national company law tribunal, if you are not following, then up to 6 months and fine of 50,000 will be there. And now the bill has removed this, whatever the provision is there, it got repealed out because of this. Small LLP, let us see by, wait. LLP Amendment Act 2021, small LLP definition. Let's see, because looks like important. Small LLP having a contribution up to 25 lakh and increased by the government maximum 5 crores and turnover 40 lakhs. LLP having contribution up to 25 lakh, maximum can be minimum 25 lakh, maximum can be a 5 crore, and turnover up to 40 lakhs immediately preceding financial year, then it can be treated as a small LLP. Two criterias. Ah, 25 lakhs, not K. IMPS limit increase from 2 lakhs to rupees. IMPS limit increase from 2 lakhs to instant so 5 lakhs immediate payment service IMPS from the 2 lakh limit to 5 lakh it got increased. For transaction limit from 2 lakh to 5 lakh it got increased. Which institution publishes Global Financial Stability Report semi-annually? So that is IMF, International Monetary Fund, Global Financial Stability Report, semi-annual publication by the IMF, which gives a detailed review of the stability of global financial markets. So IMF dedicated exclusive chapter to cryptocurrency in the report recent, which is given. Under this mentions rapid growth of crypto ecosystem presents a new opportunities at the same time. And it has cautioned about the financial stability challenges as well. After the RBI October Monetary Policy Committee meeting, what is the repo rate? Which is recent one. तो ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर 4%. आरबीआई मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी केप्ट द की लेंडिंग रेट रेपो रेट अनचेंज्ड सेम एज इट इज गिवन 4% फॉर द 8th टाइम इन अ रो. तो रिवर्स रेपो रेट इज ऑल्सो अनचेंज्ड दैट इज 3.5%. policy remains change and which is unchanged at accommodative, simply whatever the new changes were not there, exact whatever is old same as it is, they have kept it. Which rating agency has changed India's sovereign or rating outlook negative to stable? CRISIL, S&P, Moody's and Fitch. So option C is the correct answer, Moody's. Here Moody's recently changed the Indian sovereign rating outlook from negative to stable. It has highlighted India downside risk from negative feedback between the real economy and financial system are disappearing. Now the agency has also affirmed that country foreign currency, local currency are getting increased. Thereby the performance is getting increased, so that they have changed it to stable position from the negative to stable. So that's all about the current affairs. Total 77 current affairs we have discussed in the 3 sessions, which will be fruitful, as well as total all the almost important areas I covered. Still I do agree that there are important areas which can be left over, and upcoming this month current affairs also, which is September and October 5th, October entire current affairs also required to study. So for that, what I will do, when the exam is exam date sheet got declared, whenever the commerce exam happened before that 2 dates, I will discuss those current affairs within one session. Maximum 30 current affairs can be there. So that 30 will be discussed separately in single session before the 2 days of examination. And I will be sending this PDF, those who attended all the 3 sessions. You can take a screenshot of your with your name visibility. Please take a screenshot and send it to me in the Telegram. Do not forget. Today free sessions will be at 12 p.m. in the Unacademy free platform. 20 days best strategy with a daily timetable to crack the UGC NET or JRF I am going to discuss. So do attend by enrolling for free at 12 p.m. And 5:30, 7 p.m. 5:30 most frequently asked question, and 7 p.m. NTA professor expected MCQs will be there. And at 9 p.m. today, business finance in the Unacademy live NTA UGC NET YouTube channel, business finance 100 PYQ marathon is going to be there. Total combined PDF I am saying. Right, what you need to do to attend the free live session at Unacademy, just download the Unacademy Learning app, or else go through with the website of unacademy.com and select NTA UGC NET category and set examination. So if you select that one, you complete the sign up process with a Gmail and mobile number, search my name Vodnala Shivlingam, or else the link is available in the description, my profile link and my Telegram link also available. Please do join into the Telegram commerce.ugcnet, search in the Telegram as commerce.ugcnet, or else link is pinned in the chat box and also in the description it is available. Click on follow button in my profile section of Unacademy. Later go to the special classes. There you can see all the upcoming classes in the 12 p.m. today, 5:30, 7 p.m. also showing. Just click on those one, click on notify, and it will ask you the invite code Shiva Live. Enter it and attend the live session. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Have a nice day. Yes, yes, detail combined one only I will be sending. Please do hit the like button and do not forget to subscribe to this channel, Commerce Adda. It's my own channel only. Do subscribe. We'll be having a more session.